It's the Ice Juice IPO.
I'm worth $125 million.
The company is going public. Chuck's best friend, Ira, was working for the company and invested in it. And the prospect looked so good that Chuck's dad also realized the opportunity and decided to invest as well. The IPO price was set at $18, and that was already great news. The day of the IPO, the stock is booming. The boom doesn't last. It's golden frog time. It's actually engineered by Axe, who is shorting the stock and making a fortune. How much does each protagonist exactly make or lose? We know Ira was worth $125 million when the stock was priced at $18. So he's got a little less than 7 million shares. We don't know at which price Ira could access the stocks pre-IPO, but it would definitely be significantly lower than the set IPO price. We'll just say an hypothetical $12. What about Chuck Sr. now? Chuck Sr. must have bought his initial position at more or less the same price as Ira. So let's assume again $12. Then Chuck Sr. doubled his position.
Double my position.
At around $30. So this is 700,000 shares, so notional amount of $21 million. And now we can figure out how much he invested initially. Another $21 million at $12 a share. So that was 1.75 million shares. And what about Axelrod now? We don't know how many shares he sold, but he sold again around 30 or above. And let's just assume it was 3 million shares. If Axelrod closed his short at 3.89, he would make approximately $78 million. So let's summarize their individual P&Ls at $3.89. For Axelrod, that's a net gain of $78 million. Chuck Sr.'s position is worth a little less than $10 million, but that's from $40 million. So that's a significant loss of about $30 million. And for Ira, we know that his 7 million shares are now worth $27 million, 7 million shares times $3.89. And since we assume that initially got them at around $12, that would be a net loss of $56 million. Well, this episode is so good, it deserves a second analysis. What I want to look at next is how would that really work in practice? Could Axe really short the stocks? Could Ira really have become a majority shareholder? Well, thank you for watching this new episode and stay tuned as I will follow shortly with this second one. Thank you, of course, to Fintechorama for the original concept and production of these videos. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe, give it a like below, and leave me your comments further down to tell me which episodes you'd like to see analyzed next. See you soon.